Making your game feel responsive and fair is absolutely critical, otherwise you risk your player having an unenjoyable experience in an otherwise pleasant game. Ironically, this often means skewing the game unfairly in favor of your player, occasionally adding in little cheats that benefit them. Howdy, and welcome to Game Endeavor. If you want to learn more practical dev skills and improve the quality of your games, then subscribe and ding-a-ling that bell. If you're not aware of what Coyote Time is, it's a brief moment of time after the player walks over an edge that they're still able to jump. The idea being that it tricks the player into thinking that they jumped at just the right moment, when actually they missed it. Bless their heart. With all your kindness, you forgave them and said, "It's okay, little buddy. I'll give you a boost." And if you're using a capsule collider for your player, but you're not using Coyote Time, then your platforming feels awful, and I can almost promise you that. First things first, as the name would imply, we're going to need a timer. So let's go ahead and add one to our player controller. This timer will need to be extremely brief. You want it to be long enough to be useful to the player, but not so long that it's completely obvious, otherwise it will stand out. I find that 0.1 seconds is a good time for my games, but play around with this to see what works best for you. To make it easier to test, I suggest increasing this to an absurdly obvious amount, and then reducing it later. We also only want this timer to run once and then stop, so be sure to enable one shot. Inside of the script, we're also going to quickly cache our timer into an onReady variable. We want the Coyote Timer to start whenever our player becomes ungrounded, so just before we use the move and slide method in our player script, we're going to add a variable named wasGrounded, which we will store whether or not our player was on the floor before we updated. After we move, we can then use this variable to check whether or not the movement caused us to become ungrounded by saying if not is on floor and was on floor. We also only want to apply this when we're falling, but not when we're jumping. We need a way for determining this, which I already have in my player controller from the platformer series. It's a variable named isJumping, which I will set to true whenever the player presses the jump action and successfully jumps. And then we can set it to false whenever our y velocity is greater than or equal to 0. If we add this variable to our condition by saying and not isJumping, then we can be sure that the player doesn't have a little extra hop in their step. If you're using a state machine, then you don't need this condition. You can just call this next bit of logic whenever you enter the false state. If this condition is true, then we simply want to start the Coyote Timer. This timer is going to double as a boolean to determine whether or not our character is able to use the Coyote Time to their advantage, which we'll do whenever the player attempts to jump. So we'll go into our input method where we have our jump input. Move the grounded check inside of the input check, this will be useful in a minute, and then add to it by saying or not Coyote Timer dot is stopped, meaning that the timer is active so the player is still able to jump despite not being grounded. Before we celebrate though, let us stop the Coyote Timer when we jump to prevent a cheeky player from sneaking in a little extra jump. With this, you have basic Coyote Time implemented. However, you may have noticed that this is not truly Coyote Time, because the player is still affected by gravity during this time, unlike its true pioneer. This is not at all necessary, but if you want to be a stickler, then we can implement this as well. Though I will warn you that doing this could possibly have various effects on your game that I will not be able to foresee. So if this doesn't work perfectly for you, then there may be some extra steps that you will need to take to get this to work. So obviously, if we don't want gravity to affect our player during this time, then we need to go to where we're applying gravity and, well, stop it. However, you'll notice that we still fall ever so slightly after walking over a ledge. This is because there's still a small amount of gravity still being applied when we start the Coyote Timer. We need to zero this out. If you've been following along with the platformer series, then you may notice that the player slips and slides during the Coyote Time. This is because we're applying a different deceleration weight whenever we're not grounded in our method getHweight, which we use when lerping our player's horizontal velocity. We need to make it so that we apply the grounded weight whenever Coyote Time is active by adding or not Coyote Time is stopped to our isOnFloor check. And finally, we want to make it look like the player is walking on solid ground. So when we set the animation for our player, we want to make it so that we don't play the falling animation if the Coyote Time is active. And voila, your player is able to briefly defy gravity. All they need now is a sign, a canyon, and a dust particle. Another nifty trick that gets talked about a lot with Coyote Time is jump buffering. This is where the player presses jump right before they land on the ground, which normally wouldn't allow them to jump because they're not grounded. However, once the player becomes grounded, we allow them to jump. To do this, we're going to add another timer to our character, this one named Jump Buffer, and I'll also set mine to have a 0.1 duration and make sure that you disable one shot as well, otherwise you're making a platformer about pogo sticks. We're going to cast this as well into an onReady variable named Jump Buffer. We want to start this timer whenever the player presses jump, but only if they're not able to jump, so we'll go into our input method where we place the grounded logic into the method earlier. After this, we'll add an else condition where we'll start the timer by saying jumpBuffer.start. We then need to check to see if we're currently using this timer, which we'll do after our move and slide method by saying if is on floor and not jump buffer is stopped, meaning that we're on the ground but our jump buffer is active, then we're ready to jump. Then we'll say jumpBuffer.stop just as a precaution. You can never be too cautious. And finally, we'll call our jump method, and as simple as that, we've implemented jump buffering as well. If you want to learn more practical dev skills, then join our Discord to meet many other developers that are sharing their endeavor into game development. We have a friendly community and would love to see what progress you're making on your project. There's a link in the description, and I'll see you there.